Alright, so let's finalize this thing. All I need to do now is just simply add all these results together. And to do that, it's actually very simple. Again, if you remember from school when you have two sine waves, something like this, and maybe another one like this, alright? Remember that sine waves or cosine waves are additive, right? So when you add these two together, you will end by having something like this, maybe, alright? Where you have basically all those merge. So we can do exactly the same. All you need to do, for example, is add lateral movement to the rotational movement here, and then those two add to the first deformation movement, and then all that together, finally, you will add them to the last deformation movement, all right? If you connect this thing to the warp position, you will see that basically now all of them are gonna be acting together. There you go. Maybe a little bit funny. At this point we need to play with the controllers, but before doing that, I want to have like a little bit more of control. So for example, here what I want to do is create a mask, alright, where the face, I want the face to move a little bit less, and I want the tail to move more, right? And to do that, I want to create a mask that goes from black here to white in my tail, and when I multiply that for the movement, basically, the values that are closest to zero are gonna be killing the movement, and the values that are closer to one will allow the full displacement, right? And to do that, I did a little trick. So for example, here, if I open my fish, you will see that to create that mask, my first channel is not really optimal because my texture is all the way around. But I did a second channel, right, where I'm projecting my UV space depending of the y-axis, right? So basically that will allow me to use the UV coordinates node inside Unreal, where the X component is gonna start at zero, right, and it will end to one, right? So that will basically create that mask that I'm needing. So to do that, let's create a coordinate node. Texture coordinates. Of course, instead of using the coordinate index 0, we will use the index 1. Actually, if we isolate this, the axis we are interested on, and then if we connect to the base color, we can see that mask in real time. Right, so basically you will see that the face is getting black and the tail is still white. Right, so that's all we need to do. From there, all you need to do is simply multiply this mask by your movement and then reconnect this back to the warp position. Right, just compile and save, so you will see the result. Right, so there you go. Now you will see that basically the face is moving less. Actually, I'm not entirely happy with this thing because the very tip of my head, right, it's basically full black, meaning that it's zero movement. Maybe I just want a little bit of more of movement right there, so it's not like that really static. And to do that, what I can do is create another controls to create some offset here for my masking. And remember that this is basically 0 to 1 values. What we can do is simply add a number right there. So for example, that 0 plus, I don't know, 0.1, all right, will become, of course, in 0.1, and that 0.1 will allow a little bit of movement in my multiplication here. So let's do that. Let's add something here. Let's create a controller, and I'm gonna call this thing mask offset, like so. The default should be 1. And in this case, I want to avoid the negative values, right? Otherwise, we will have something weird when I multiply something negative by this value. And to do that, remember that we can saturate. So basically, that will allow me to crop all those values to be always between 0 and 1. Right? Let me just multiply. And I guess let me just connect this thing as well into the base color so we can see the masking having that offset in real time too. right? So for now, it's basically the same result, but if I add something here, you will see that basically now my face is moving just a little bit, all right? So that's all. At this point, all we need to do is play with the controllers. So let me just connect the texture into my base color. And then from there, you will need to play with the speed, with the angles, with the movement, right? And that's gonna be up to you. So for example, in this case, maybe I want my fish to swim like a little bit fast, something like that. Actually, that looks prime, kind of cool. Yeah, it looks cool. Maybe I want to increase a little bit the amplitude in the Z axis, maybe just 5. Actually, maybe more. Yeah, that's way too much. Yes, 10 was okay. Well, like I said, that's the end of this tutorial. From there, it's just up to you what you want to do with your animation, but that's it, right? So thank you for watching.